Hello, welcome back to a presentation on Mechanics of Materials under the initiative of VTU eShikshana program. We are doing module 5 columns. In this series, this is lecture 3. And in the previous lecture, we studied about the types of columns used in various applications and the different end conditions and for the equations for the each end condition, that is Euler's crippling load. For different end conditions, we derived the equations. Today, we'll see the limitations of Euler's theory. So after studying the Euler's equation for different end conditions, now there is a drawback of Euler's theory or limitations of Euler's theory. Let us look into that. Now, this expression we have already derived, that is for Euler's equation. We have seen that the crippling load in case of a column is given by pi square EI by L square. This is called Euler's crippling load or the limiting load or the maximum load beyond which the column fails. Now we need to design a column so that the column is subjected to a load which is much below the crippling load. Now this is given by pi square EI by L square, where E is the Young's modulus, I is the moment of inertia, and L is the length of the column. Now here, the moment of inertia can be given by the product of A into K square, where A is the cross-section area of the column, and K is the radius of gyration, least radius of gyration. So now, if I substitute in this equation of PCR is equal to pi square EI by L square, in place of I, if I substitute I is equal to AK square, then if I take K in the denominator, so this can be written like L by K whole square. Already L square is there. So K square, if I take, so L by K whole square. So the equation can be modified as the Euler's crippling load is equal to pi square E into A divided by L by K whole square. Now this is the load what we are talking about, crippling load. But what is the limiting stress? If I want to find the stress, we know that stress is equal to load by area, or crippling stress is equal to crippling load by the cross-section area. Now if I substitute in this equation, the equation PCR here, so I'll get limiting stress or crippling stress is equal to, in place of PCR, I'll substitute pi square EI by L by K whole square. A is already there, divided by A. So A gets cancelled here. So what remains is pi square E by L by K whole square. So this is the limiting stress or the crippling stress for which we need to design a column for safe operation, where this term L by K is called as a slenderness ratio. So the Euler's crippling stress is limited with respect to L by K. In this equation, you can see the stresses are larger for a smaller value of L by K and vice versa. That we can see from the graph here. Now in this graph we have drawn, on the x-axis you can see the slenderness ratio, L by K, and on the y-axis you have the crippling load, crippling stress, sigma CR. And if we draw a series of stresses values and the various ratios of L by K for different columns, then a graph will arrive at a graph like this. You can see a graph here. Now this graph clearly indicates that at lower values of L by K, the stresses are too high. You can see here, small values of L by K, the values of stresses are very high, and it stresses go on decreasing as L by K value increases. So that means this theory holds good for longer columns. L by K means the slenderness ratio, which determines the ratio of length by radius of gyration. So this Euler's theory holds good for longer columns, And in case of shorter columns, the stresses are too high and the buckling or the failure takes place for short columns. So the equation cannot be used for short columns. So we can see here significant points here. P, Q is now sigma CR is the crippling stress maximum, and sigma P is the stress corresponding to the proportional limit. Okay. That means you need to design the column only if it is having a L by K ratio in this region, that is below sigma P only, you can use the Euler's equation, not above that. So that is the major limitation of Euler's theory. So Euler's theory can be applied only for long, slender columns, not for the short columns. So we can see here the variation of crippling stress with slenderness ratio in the graph. Some of the observations that you can make here: if slenderness ratio is small, crippling stress are too high, and as L by K tends to zero, stresses become infinite, very high. Then stress corresponding to proportional limit is sigma P, and sigma CR is the critical stress, limiting stress. So that means Euler's formula is valid only if it gives a value of crippling stress less than proportional limit. That means it is valid only in this region, below sigma P. Hence, Euler's formula is applicable only for column with larger slenderness ratio. L by K ratio is larger, so that is only in case of long columns. So therefore, Euler's formula is applicable for long slender columns only. So here, the limiting value is sigma CR is equal to sigma P. That means we can design only up to this value. That if I substitute, take this value of limiting stress, sigma CR is equal to sigma P as a limiting stress, and if I substitute in the equation, Euler's equation, pi square E by L by K whole square is equal to, instead of sigma CR, if I take it as sigma P, then I can modify the equation. If I take L by K whole square on the left side equal to pi square E by sigma P, or L by K is equal to square root of pi square E by sigma P. So slenderness ratio equation, to find slenderness ratio, the best value of slenderness ratio, you can use pi square E by sigma P, provided you know Young's modulus for the material of which the column is made and the proportional limit for that particular material. So that means slenderness ratio can be found out by using this equation. Let us see one example how we can find. For example, if you have MS, mild steel, for which Young's modulus is 2.1 into 10 to the power 5 Newton per mm square, and its proportionality limit is 330 Newton per mm square. So if I substitute in this equation, L by K is equal to pi square E by sigma P, pi square, in place of E, I substitute this value of Young's modulus for the material MS and proportionality limit 330, I will get the value as 80. So that means if L by K, in case of mild steel, if L by K is less than 80, the Euler formula is not valid. So that is the restriction or drawback of a Euler's theory or Euler's crippling load. So for if you want to use MS in a column, then you have to have a slenderness ratio greater than 80, L by K ratio greater than 80. So now, to overcome this drawback of Euler's theorem, Rankine developed a formula, that is Rankine's formula. Let us see the Rankine's formula. Because Euler's formula, we know that is valid for only long slender columns. But Rankine's formula, which was derived, was suitable for long, medium, and short columns. And what this theory says, as per Rankine's theory, the relation exists between crippling load, PCR, then crushing load, PC, and the Euler's buckling load, PE. So that means in Euler's theory, the crushing load was neglected. But here we are considering the crushing load. So that means the critical load PCR is equal to 1 by PC plus 1 by PE. Okay. So we have to consider both the buckling load and crushing load. Buckling load in case of long columns and crushing load in case of short columns. So both should be considered for the critical load. Now, first we'll take three cases here, one long column, one short column, and one medium column. So first we'll take the case of a long column. In case of long column, the failure normally occurs by buckling. The crushing load is very small compared to PE, so hence neglecting that. So in case of long columns, PCR becomes equal to PE, okay? So that is Euler's load is equal to the crippling load. Whereas in case of medium columns, both PE and PCR consider, you need to consider both PE and PC. That is the load due to crushing and load due to buckling. And if you take 1 by PCR is equal to 1 by PC plus 1 by PE, I can write for PCR by rearranging the equation, which is equal to product of PC into PE divided by PC plus PE, or PCR is also equal to, if you're taking PE down, I can write PC by 1 plus PC by PE. Or I can write PCR is equal to sigma C into A and 1 plus sigma C into bracket, we can write A by pi square EI by L square. I substituted for the load here for PE, that is Euler's load, pi square EI by L square. So rearranging the equation, sigma C into A divided by 1 plus sigma C into A divided by pi square E. Instead, in place of I substitute AK square. I know that moment of inertia is product of area into K square divided by L square. So rearranging the equation, sigma C into A divided by 1 plus sigma C by pi square E. In the bracket, I can take L by K whole square. If I take L above, so it becomes L by K. So the terms having square are separated here. L by K whole square. So rearranging the equation, PCR is equal to sigma C into A divided by 1 plus alpha into L by K whole square. Okay. So now, if I write the equation, so here alpha is taken as the Rankine constant. The Rankine constant is this here. This term can be taken as the Rankine constant, when K is the radius of variation. Now, this Rankine formula can be finally written as sigma C into A divided by 1 plus alpha into L by K whole square. Now, for mild steel, this value of Rankine's constant alpha, he lies at a value of 1 by 7500 and sigma C crushing stress 320 Newton per mm square. And for this is for mild steel. For cast iron, it is around 1 by 1600 and crushing stress is 550 Newton per mm square. And for, if you compare other material, timber, it is very less, that is 1 by 1750 and sigma C is 50 Newton per mm square. Now, this is the equation for the medium column. So PCR is equal to sigma C into A divided by 1 plus alpha into L by K whole square, where alpha is the Rankine constant. Now, last case is for short columns. In case of short columns, failure occurs due to crushing load. So PE is very small compared to PC. So hence, we are neglecting PE here. Then the equation becomes 1 by PCR is equal to 1 by PC. So our PCR is equal to PC. That means the critical or crippling load is equal to crushing load. So this is the Rankine equation. And Euler's equation already we have derived for different end conditions. So these two equations we have to apply in solving various problems related to the applications. Now, just summarizing the formula here, we have defined the different end conditions, like both ends are hinged, both ends are fixed, one end fixed and other end is free, one end fixed and other end hinged. So we have four conditions here for the columns in applications. And Euler's buckling load equation You can see here the equation pi square ei by l square is same for all the different end conditions, but what changes is the effective length. So in case of both ends hinged, effective length is equal to the total length, whereas in case of both ends fixed, the effective length is half of the actual length. Then in one end fixed, other end is free, the effective length is twice the actual length. And one end fixed and other end is hinged, L is equal to L by root. So we have to solve number, we'll solve some of the problems on Euler's theory to find the buckling load and how to design the columns safe for safe service. So where the, we cannot use this Euler's theory, we can use Rankine's formula, which is PCR is equal to sigma C into A by 1 by alpha into L by K whole square. Let us solve some problems on this two equations. Let us consider the first problem, that is a solid circular bar of 60 mm diameter cross section is used as a column. So it is a circular column having 60 mm diameter. What is asking is find the safe compressive load, that is the crippling load for the column. In case of, there are two cases given here. One is both ends are fixed. The columns, both ends are fixed here. In the second case, one end is, both ends are hinged here, pinned. So for these two cases, for the material used, Young's modulus is 2.1 into 10 to the power 5 Newton per mm square. And your allowable factor of safety is 3. And also take the actual length of the column as 2.5 meters. So how to find the safe, how to design the column for a safe compressive load, you can see here. Let us write the given data. Diameter 60 mm. Length is given in meters, convert. Then factor of safety is 3. And then the Young's modulus is 2.1 into 10 to the power 5 Newton per mm square. So we know that factor of safety is very important, because even though the failure takes place at a particular load, we need to make sure that we need to design the column for a much load, much value of a load which is much below than the actual load at which it fails. So that is why we are choosing a factor of safety. Now Euler's length, Euler's equation for both ends, when both ends are hinged, it is L is equal to L. So effective length is also equal to actual length of the column, that is 2500 mm. And we need moment of inertia here. Since it is circular column, moment of inertia is given by pi by 64 into d to the power 4 or 60 to the power 4. Now this is the value of moment of inertia, because we need moment of inertia in finding the crippling load. So we'll write the crippling load equation. PCR is equal to pi square ei by L square. So substitute the value of Young's modulus, moment of inertia. All you make sure that you substitute all the values in mm, then length is also 2500 mm. So we'll get a crippling load of 200 into 10 to the power of 3 newtons. But we need to design the column for a much safer load. So that is why we're choosing factor of safety. Dividing by factor of safety, I'll get the value as around 67 into 10 to the power of newton, 10 to the power of 3 newtons, or 67 kilonewtons. So for the given solid circular bar column, the critical or crippling load according to Euler's theory is 67 kilonewtons. That is for the first case when both ends are fixed. Now let us see when both ends are hinged. The difference here is the effective length changes here. The effective length is equal to L by 2. So that is 1250 mm, which is half. That is what we have taken in case of both ends fixed. So now, again, substituting in the PCR equation, pi square ei by L square, I value remains same because cross-section diameter is same. So only the length changes here. Instead of 2,500, we are substituting 1,250. And you will get a load of around 803682 newtons. Dividing by factor of safety, we will get 267.8 into 10 to the power of 3 newtons. and which is nothing but 267.8 kilonewtons. So that is how you can design a column based on its end condition and the type of material used and other factors, cross-section area. Similarly, in the second problem, you can see a column circular. This is all circular in section, has 28 mm diameter. Now it has both ends fixed here and subjected to an axial compressive load. Determine the minimum length of the column by Euler's formula. Take the compressive stress 320 MPa and Young's modulus 200 GPa. So here in this case, he has asked the minimum length of the column as per the Euler's theory. Let us write the given values: diameter 280 mm, sigma c 320 MPa, converting into Newton per mm square. Then Young's modulus converted into Newton per mm square. So here from MPa to Newton per mm square, GPa to Newton per mm square. So cross section area is 615 mm square. So now if I take for a circular section, I is equal to pi by 64 d4. Substitute the value of diameter, we'll get the value of this moment of inertia. Then taking the PCR value, pi square EI by LE square. So PCR is equal to, we know that load is equal to stress into area, because here stress is given in this problem. So let us take the equation stress into area. Stress into area is equal to 320 into 615 is equal to pi square EI by LE square. Here L is unknown and he is asked the length of the column. From this, I'll get a length of 550 mm. But in case of ends, both ends fixed here, condition given, the effective length is half of the actual length. So that means L is equal to 60 into 2, that is 1100. So actual length of the column is 1100 mm. And what we got is effective length only, for which the buckling can take place. So this is another problem on finding the designing the column. Let us take one more problem here. A column 2 meters long, 2 meters long, has a square section. Now the difference between the previous problem and this one is that it is a square section of sides 40 mm. Okay. Then taking factor of safety is 4, determine the safe load for following conditions. So all the 4 conditions are given here. One end fixed, other end free. Both ends are fixed. Both ends are hinged. And one end fixed, another end is hinged. So the equation remains same, but the effective length equation changes. So let us do it for first one. Length is given 2 meters, convert into millimeters. And then we have breadth 40 mm, factor of safety 4, Young's modulus 210 GPa. So here, see the equation changes. In case of circular, it is pi d fourth by 64. Here, I is equal to bd cube by 12. So breadth into depth, it is a square section. Both are 40-40. So we'll get the value of I. Then in first case, that is one end fixed, other end is free. If I take the effective length is twice the actual length, so 4000 millimeters. Then if I substitute in the equation of crippling load, pi square EI by LE square, so pi square into Young's modulus into I divided by effective length square, I will get the crippling load as 27.5 into 10 to the power of 3 newtons. So using this factor of safety for design is very important. I will get the safe load as 6.9 kilonewtons. Now this is for the first case. In second case, that is both ends are fixed. When both ends are fixed, effective length is half of the actual length. So you will get 1100 mm. Again, substituting in the equation, PCR equal to pi square EI by LE square. So always remember, you substitute effective length, not the actual length here. Then Young's modulus, moment of inertia, you will get the value of the crippling load for the second case. In the third case, when both the ends are hinged, the effective length is actually equal to the actual length. So again, you substitute in the equation of PCR, pi square EI by LE square. Now this is the effective length, you will get the crippling load. Again, do not forget to divide by the factor of safety. You will get the safe load in this case as 27.6 kilonewtons. Now, the final case, that is fourth case, one end is fixed and other end is hinged. The effective length is L by LE is equal to L by root 2, actual length by root 2. So taking this length and substituting in the equation PCR, I'm substituting here effective length. Then I'll get the critical or crippling load as 221 into 10 to the power of 3. So dividing by factor of safety, I will get the value 55.3 to 10 to the power of 3 newtons, or can be expressed as safe load is equal to 55.3 kilonewtons.